It's a place there's just you. That's perfect. Welcome to the Rosewood Library. I don't believe I've seen you here before. Is that correct? New visitor. Good, good. Well, pleased to welcome you to our fine establishment here. We boast 3 floors filled to the brim with books, magazines, and records meticulously collected and maintained. We are open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, so you are welcome to come enjoy our amenities at any moment you please. The place is entirely furnished with luxury velvet furniture that I assure you will struggle to arise from. Favorite feature of mine would be the intricately designed stained glass windows. The light cascades through them in the most fabulous fashion. Then there are the carved mahogany staircases they encourage me to inform you of, but I simply struggle to see. Then, how do you feel about nooks? We do offer an abundance of nooks. Yeah, perfect to cozy up in and study. We do take great pride in our offerings here at Rosewood, and I sincerely hope that you come to find the place much like a second home in due time. I can understand why you'd wander in on this particular day. Dreadfully dreary out, isn't it? Can't blame you for wanting to escape it. What a lovely collection of books you've found. Somewhat of a rainbow, isn't it? So, you'd like to take all of these home with you today, I presume. Well, that's perfect. I'm exactly the gal you'll need. I'll get these all signed and stamped for you. Yours for the month, all right? I'll just need your telephone number, home address, and full name, all right? That's good. So, that's... Oh, by the fountain. I see. And is that with a T? Good. All right. And your name, please. Ah! Oh, yes. I've been expecting you. Yes, my sister mentioned you might be stopping by one of these days. Quite pleased to finally meet. She's spoken highly. There's all that squared away. Well, with all these books, lengthy train ride. Ah, I see. Well, I hope they will keep you sufficiently entertained. It looks like the first is a little leather flower guide with the most gorgeous golden embossing over the cover. Featuring California poppies, the flower guide. Flowers east of the Rockies. Do love a leather-bound book. It is filled with the most darling little paintings of each blossom. I would gladly hang any one of them on my wall. Let's see, there's the thick walled mountain. both the one apple. Swamp honeysuckle, the violet, monk crown, bouncy bit, yellow fringed orange iris, dog tooth, majesticus, titillatus, absolute abundance, dog bane, blue toad, fox, it's just my white belly, flasting, so in the inside cover. Each book, we've got this little envelope with the collection card. We feature a different stamp each month. It's just a bit easier for us to keep track of things. So, need to put your name as well as the date. And then this month, using this little frond of leaves, the mulberry ink, just seal the deal that you are borrowing, tuck that back into the envelope, So we'll be expecting this back by the 28th of next month, or I'll find you. Only joking, it's simply a modest 50 cent fee will apply. So, that went all squared away. Next up seems to be Good Men and True by Eugene Manlove Rhodes. Gorgeous illustrations throughout. They really bring the tale to life. Eugene proves himself a masterful storyteller. It's a quite tense but humorous tale that follows a brave young man in deadly peril on the Texan border. Are you a fan of westerns? Boots and bars and horses, what's not to like, really? Riveting read by my standards. It'll come in handy if you ever find yourself well and truly bored to death. I read it myself when the ferry took twice as long as scheduled, thanks to a severely overslept captain. This illustration right at the beginning. And how are we now? You're my young friend. How are we now, my young friend? How are we now, my young friend? Appears to be this group of men. Checked out quite a few many times. Understandably why. Novel quite popularity. It's quite mysterious in nature. So good to put that. Like step left. The date today. Good moment of truth. Yours for the month. Right. Let's see what's next. Checking the spelling in your letters. That's a fine idea. There's not much to make a suitor more attractive than good sense. It's also help you with your rhyming skills quite a bit. If you'd care to compare the to a cherry blossom tree, some other such words of affirmation, which is perfect. Excellent for vocabulary, spelling, and rhymes. So, this. Sign that away, and then step it away. Perfect. Bella, book one, it's yours for the month. Sure hope it does you well. Next up is that printer. Glad to see you with this. I would recommend it quicker than a heartbeat. Please, pistachio green book cover. Harold Bell Wright, distinguished fellow here. He follows the journey of a struggling young man who runs away from home. Is eventually taken in by a kind-hearted fellow named George Udell, a local publisher. He provides him with work, spiritual guidance, overall far, far happier life. It's a quite uplifting tale. Harold has a way of making you fall in love with his characters. You'll feel compelled to pick up the book again and again and again, just to see what they're up to, like the old friends of yours. There's a few pictures in this one as well. I quite like that. As nice as it can be to exercise your own imagination, I do prefer to be explicitly shown how the author imagines the people to look. It just gives me some sort of peace of mind, I suppose. Fine. Here's illustrations for you. Tom Wharton, you liar and a cheat. So you can see the accuser here looking smart. Pointing at Tom Wharton. supposed liar, cheat. I just love to be able to like picturing them in my mind's eye, just precisely as the author intended, you know. Wonderful, wonderful. Very excited for you to be reading these. Looks like this one has been left out once and twice. The young folks shelf of books, rich collection of classics for your enjoyment. More of a collection of poetry than stories, I might say, just due to their brevity. But perfect for capturing, keeping your attention. Illustrated too, nearly everyone comes with a charming little picture. I find this one to be well suited to enjoying with others, actually. If you and a friend find yourselves idle, it's quite good fun to take turns reading rhymes to one another. I do have a perfect one for a rainy night like this. It's called something like A Story for a Child. Found it, my favourite from a young folks' shelf of books. It's called A Story for a Child. Little one, come to my knee. Hark how the rain is pouring over the roof in the pitch black night, and the wind in the woods is roaring. Hush. Father was lost in the pitch black night in just such a storm as this is. High up on the lonely mountains, where the wild men watched and waited, wolves in the forest and bears in the bush, and I on my path belated. The rain and the night together came down, and the wind came after, bending the props of the pine tree roof and snapping many a rafter. I crept along. Something rustled, two green eyes shone, and a wolf lay down beside me. Little one, be not frighted. I and the wolf together, side by side through the long, long night, hid from the awful weather. His wet fur pressed against me. Each of us warmed the other. Each of us felt in the stormy dark that beast and man was brother. And when the falling forest no longer crashed in warning, each of us went from our hiding place, forth in the wild, wet morning. Darling, kiss me in payment. how the wind is roaring. Father's house is a better place when the stormy rain is pouring.
It really is true that oftentimes stories are vastly improved by the presence of a rainstorm. But I'd say that one is wonderful. It's all right. Would you agree?
Your next selection, say collection, of the famous poet Baudelaire's work. Are you familiar? Highly, highly controversial at the time of publication due to scandalous themes such as romance, corruption, melancholy, death, and wine. So scandalous, in fact, that six of the poems in this very collection were banned. Not only banned, but poor Baudelaire was prosecuted for creating an offence against public morals. I can believe that. A few fellow poets, thankfully, spoke out in support, such as Victor Hugo, I believe it was, said, "Your work shines. Applaud your vigorous spirit with all my might." So, thankfully, us not so small-minded folk can enjoy this work to our heart's content. Lovely, rough, alligator skin textured print. So I'm just going to be quickly typing up a record of collections of everything you're checking out today, just so that you'll be able to easily keep track of exactly what is due on what date. And so it seems that first we have that flower guide by Chester A. Reed from 1950. The Rosewood Library National Record of Collection, 1929. Flower Guide. Good Men and True. Spell it 1. Print a few dolls. Young folks love books. And play his prose and poetry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can see there's a spot with the signature of the archivist. I'm going to pack it away for you. It's a little envelope. I do hope to see you back soon. I assure you, I know this place.